Forget gurus. Forget anyone claiming to be an online business expert without going through the challenges of entrepreneurship themselves. The Real Money, Real Business podcast is here to prove the best insights in online business comes from your fellow online business builders. We dig into stories of entrepreneurs selling their business on the Empire Flippers marketplace so that you can learn how they made their business profitable, how they overcame obstacles, and what lessons they learned in their online journey. If you want to take your business and your knowledge to the next level, you've come to the right podcast. Let's get started.
Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of the Real Money, Real Business podcast. We record these interviews so potential buyers have more information about the seller and the business to help them make a buying decision. Before we dive in, let's go over a brief summary of this business. It is an affiliate and display advertising business created in February of 2019 in the information niche. The average monthly revenue for the business is $8,542 and it makes an average of $7,962 per month in net profit. The assets included in the sale are primary domain and all site content and files, a secondary domain, social media accounts, which include Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn, an email list with over 1,400 subscribers, an AdThrive account, Cloudflare account, and Cloudways server. So for everyone listening, you can visit empireflippers.com/marketplace and search for listing 61328 to learn more about the business, or you can unlock this listing to start your due diligence if you're interested in purchasing this asset. So that's a brief overview of the business for sale. Let's hear from the seller with me today. So welcome to the show, Sander. How are you doing today?
Thank you. I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm doing great as well. And I'm looking forward to learning more about you and your business. So to start us off, can you tell us a little bit about your background in building and running online businesses?
Sure. So my background in running online businesses started in 2016. Before that point, in terms of education, I actually had a degree in medical diagnostics, which is totally unrelated. But after finishing my degree and a few stints of work in hospitals, I realized that this work was not really for me, and building online businesses seemed more like the type of lifestyle that I wanted. And I already had some basic self-taught knowledge of programming, and I had always been quite interested in the research and writing processes, so I figured, why not give it a shot? So with those thoughts in mind, I started my first website, which was also an affiliate website, and I ended up selling that first website for low six figures back in 2019. That project was much more simple and basic than the one we are discussing today. But from what I can see from SEO tools, even that simple website is still doing really well to this day.
Well, that's great to hear, actually. And congratulations on this being your second business that is in a position to be sold.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, and it is good to hear about how businesses are doing after the sale, as we don't always get that information. But yeah, so that's great to hear about that first business. Let's talk about the niche for this business. Why did you choose this niche?
Sure. So the topic of online education is one I've always been quite interested in, especially after my career switch from medicine to digital marketing. I realized by myself firsthand that there is quite a lot of potential in online learning and it can really help a lot of people. But before moving ahead with the actual decision to start a business, I started doing a ton of background research to figure out whether there is really a kind of gap in the market that my website could fill. And what I found was that in terms of keywords, there were a lot of, even thousands of actionable high-value keywords that the site could target with an organic campaign. And even to this day, many of these keywords are quite low-hanging fruits and waiting to be targeted. And after keyword research, another thing I typically do right away is competitor analysis. That all showed that there were some existing sites which were already in this space, but they tended to be quite poor quality and kind of thin affiliate websites, which could potentially be overtaken with superior content, backlinks, and just an overall better design. And then I searched around for some potential affiliate partners, and that was also quite promising because there were many multi-billion dollar businesses who were searching for affiliates, and their commission rates were also far superior to those you see on Amazon or the other more general affiliate networks. all these different things put together showed that this was quite a promising niche, and quite quickly I decided to move ahead and launch the website.
Very nice. That's a lot of, it's like a combination of course, you said you're interested, but also a lot of technical like research that went into making this decision. So it's very cool to hear about the different pieces of information that you use to ultimately choose this niche, and I guess the angle or how specifically you would get into this niche.
Yeah.
Very cool. Okay. Now, why are you deciding to sell the business instead of keeping it and growing it?
Yeah, so there are a couple of reasons which led to this decision. One thing is that at this point, I have already written about the topics that I was interested in and most passionate about, such as online learning analysis and study methods. And at this point, I already feel like it's a good point for me to move on from this website and focus on new endeavors. There is definitely some big potential in expanding the content even further, but in general, I just tend to find myself less passionate about the later stages of operating websites, and I tend to prefer the initial kind of exciting growth stage where you have to come up with new solutions and kind of create a new design and figure out how you can make some new cool type of content. And I tend to prefer those procedures rather than simply following through on existing procedures and simply grinding the same process. And one more factor is that at this point, I would like to have some upfront funds from a sale rather than a continuous stream of income, because I'm planning to buy a home this summer, and that would be really helpful as well.
Nice. I guess the more experienced you get, you realize that there is a difference between the building phase of a business and then the operating part. And some people love both. Some people love the building part, and some people love just having the asset and being able to continue working on it and growing it. But there are definitely two different types of work.
Yeah, for sure. There are different stages.
Yep. Okay. So this business, you built this up to be very successful. So what did you learn from building this that just seemed to work?
I think a couple of things worked really well with this website. One thing that I focused on was a low-risk, slow-growth strategy rather than a kind of high-risk, high-growth strategy, because from the very beginning, I knew that the site would start getting traffic basically exclusively from Google search, and I didn't really want to wake up every day being afraid of the next big Google algorithm update. So I placed as much emphasis as possible on staying by Google's guidelines and trying to stay on their good side, if for not any other reason than just so that I could sleep easy at night.
Sure.
And I focused on fewer but more higher quality and evergreen types of content. And I think led to the site basically withstanding every Google algorithm update to this point. And it has not had traffic fluctuation like many other affiliate sites have had recently.
Got it.
Yeah. And I think a lot other thing which worked really well was putting as much emphasis as possible on the content side of things, because from my experience, content is in the end what makes or breaks a website. And with this site, I made sure to actually put in the time to research each topic, use high quality authoritative sources, and just trying to focus as much as possible on the user experience and writing for the people rather than the machines. But at the same time, I tried to also cover the machine side of things by adding schema, by structuring the content well, and so on and so forth. So content, I think, really good success story in this website. I think placing so much emphasis on content really worked out well.
Yeah, very nice. The balance between writing for humans and for the algorithm, I think, is an important balance to strike properly. So yeah, I'm glad to hear about that.
One more thing I would add is that with this site, I only focused on the higher tier types of link building. I didn't use the shady strategies that many other affiliates tend to use, like these PBNs or redirects or any other type of methods like that. I only focused on natural link bait content, which worked really well actually with this website, and also some help a reporter out link building, Haro link building. And these two methods put together actually were also super successful with this website. So I'm really satisfied with the link building efforts as well.
Oh, that's awesome. Sounds like you did quite a few things that worked out well. Was there anything you tried with this business that didn't work out as well?
Yeah, so looking back, I would definitely change one thing about the business plan, and that is focusing more on display ads. I have always, throughout my years, been focused fully just on affiliate revenue, but now I realize that there is a ton of potential in display ads as well. And as the site has been getting traffic for quite a long time already, then probably I missed out on like tens of thousands of dollars worth of display ad earnings by now. So there is quite a lot of missed opportunity there. And I definitely think it was a mistake not to add display ads to the site sooner. And I think in terms of the future, I would think that steering the focus of the site more towards display ad revenue is definitely a smart and kind of low risk direction for the website.
Yeah. Well, you may have just answered this next question then. So it's about the opportunities. So if you were to keep the business, what are some ways you would try to grow it? So it definitely sounds like focusing more on the display advertising revenue stream would be one major thing you'd focus on. Is that right?
Yeah, for sure. Focusing more on display ad revenue is definitely a direction I would take for the site, because there are just so many good keywords and high traffic and high value keywords that you can target. And generally, the competition is quite weak. Many websites are very outdated. So in terms of just growing the traffic by a large margin, I think that's really achievable. And display ads are quite traffic dependent. And I think the synergy of the two would be really quite good. But moving on from display ads to the affiliate, I think there are also many opportunities there. One would be kind of the obvious avenue for growth, which is expanding the site's affiliate content. Right now, the site has only covered a small fraction of potential topics that could be covered. And I think there are definitely lots of opportunities to write different kinds of reviews and roundup articles and any other types of affiliate content. Also, the site's domain is very broad and not exact match. So there are lots of opportunities in terms of the domain name to also expand into new content categories and dig down on some of those sub-niches. Until now, the site has been largely focused on online learning. Online learning is a very broad topic, and there's definitely some opportunity to drill deeper into some of the sub-niches. And besides that, I think some quick wins could also be gained by updating outdated content. And another quick win could be gained from renegotiating the existing commission rates with the partners. So far, I have never initiated such negotiations myself, but there is a kind of multi-year history of really good earnings and lots of communication with the partners. So I think as a result of these good relationships, it's quite likely that some of them would be willing to increase their commission rates with the site. And finally, I think also email marketing is a good thing to mention, because right now the email list is already more than 1,400 subscribers, but it's totally unmonetized. So someone who knows a bit of email marketing could definitely put these subscribers to use as well. So yeah, that's, I think, about all that's coming to my mind right now.
Well, certainly a lot of opportunities for growth here. Of course, there is always a degree of risk with any business model. So what do you think are the biggest risks with this business that a buyer should be aware of?
Google, for sure. The biggest risk definitely comes from Google.
Yeah.
With any business that is built on organic traffic, the site is still reliant on Google's algorithms. Especially in recent years, Google's algorithm updates have been increasing in frequency. But the site has stayed stable throughout these updates. But you still never know 100%, so it's a risk factor for sure. I think it's worth mentioning, though, that I have taken quite a lot of precautions to insulate the site against any possible algorithm changes, because I built the site from the ground up with Google's guidelines in mind. So I try to do absolutely everything by the book and avoid any kind of shady strategies like low quality affiliate content, thin affiliate content, PBNs, redirects, or any other shady strategies that are bound to get discovered by Google's algorithm sooner or later. So I avoided all of that. I think that definitely reduces the risk quite a lot. And I think another risk that is often associated with sites in the affiliate space is that affiliate offers can be changed, removed, updated, lowered. We saw this with Amazon quite a short while back. While this site still has this risk to an extent, as it's an affiliate site, I have worked really hard on diversifying the affiliate income streams, with as much partners as possible. And right now, the site already has income-generating affiliate partnerships with more than 20 brands. And I think this does reduce this risk to a large extent, because even if one partner decides to cut their rates, then the others will just stay unaffected. So it does reduce this risk quite a bit. So yeah, I think that's about it.
Nice. Yeah, there's always the risk with the traffic source being from dependent on Google, and you have an answer there, and you've diversified your revenue streams. So yeah, it seems like you've really worked to reduce the risk on this specific business within this model. Nice. Yeah. Okay, great. So let's wrap up with some housekeeping questions. So first question is, how much support are you willing to offer a new buyer?
So I decided to offer 60 days of email support together with one call per week, which is 8 calls in total. I decided to give this extra support because I have built everything on the site myself and I wanted to ensure a smooth transition to the buyer. So I wanted to go a little bit beyond what is typically expected from a sale like this.
Yes, beyond the default support period of 30 days. Excellent.
Yeah.
Okay, great. And would you commit to a non-compete on this business after it's sold?
Yeah, definitely. I can sign a non-compete. One thing maybe worth mentioning is that I do have one other small website, which I would like to request to have the right to monetize with a few of the same affiliate partners. But this site does not cover any of the same topics as the one we are discussing today. And that is why I'm also happy to sign a non-compete. And also, when people unlock the listing of this business, they will see the URL of the small website I'm talking about. So if they have any doubts, they can just check it out.
Yep, great. Thanks for sharing that. And yes, for any buyers listening who unlock the listing, then you can also discuss this directly with Sander. Okay. Last question is, are you open to something like an earnout?
Yeah, I have done earnouts in the past and they have actually worked out really well for both myself and the buyer's side. So I don't really see any reason why we couldn't negotiate a deal like that as well. Also, I'm not really set on any final conditions or any final multiples. So if anyone wants to negotiate, please feel free to reach out.
Okay. And are you open to something like an earnout?
Yeah, for sure. I have done earnouts in the past and those have worked out well for both myself and the buyer's side. So I don't see any reason why we couldn't negotiate something like that. I'm also not really dead set on any other final conditions or final multiples. So if anyone wants to negotiate, please feel free to reach out and we can discuss.
Nice. Okay. And last questions, if they're relevant. Putting yourself in the shoes of a buyer, why do you think this is a business worth buying?
Yeah, so typically when I'm in the role of the buyer, I tend to look for sites that have a brandable domain. They have high quality original content, a clean and strong backlink profile, are stable and are in a niche that has plenty of room for expansion. I think this business definitely ticks all of these boxes, and that is why I also think that this site would be a really strong asset in any content website portfolio, especially those focusing on affiliate or display ads. And whether it's expanding into new topic categories, optimizing the display ad revenue, or even things like renegotiating commission rates, I think there are tons of opportunities to grow this site further in the right hands. And that is why I think it's definitely a business worth buying.
Yes, definitely seems like there are a lot of opportunities here for growth. Okay. Well, last question then. Is there anything you'd like to add that you think I might have missed during the interview?
Yeah, one thing which I think is maybe worth mentioning is that this site is quite unique and difficult to replicate at present time because of the COVID pandemic. During the pandemic, there was this boom of online learning, and as a result, this site also was a part of it. It got hundreds of really good links and more than 100 academic citations within high-quality research journals, and achieving this on a new site starting out right now would be, I think, next to impossible because you just can't replicate what happened back in 2020. And all of the references and all of these citations and all of this kind of publicity which was gained during the COVID period will definitely continue to be a strong asset for this site moving forward.
Yeah, that's a great answer. And that's a very interesting point that you bring up. I haven't heard that before about just increasing the competitiveness through the 2+ years during the pandemic. Great. Well, Sander, I'm going to wrap this up here. So thank you so much for sharing your story and joining us on today's episode. And yeah, I hope your business is purchased in the near future and by the right buyer.
Thank you so much, Nick. It was a pleasure to talk to you.
Yeah, you as well. All right, everyone. Thanks for listening. To learn more and see if this listing has already been sold, head over to empireflippers.com/marketplace and search for listing number 61328. And if you're watching this on YouTube, click the link in the description to go straight to the listing. And once you've unlocked this listing, you'll be given everything you need to know about this business. So until next time, enjoy your digital journey.